So today I have some really sad news that I want to talk about, but I do hope that there is a message that you can get out of this, and hopefully it's going to spread across in this video. Now, last night these two kids were playing a competitive Call of Duty game. I'm not going to give their names because I don't want to give them any type of publicity, but apparently they were in a UMG wager match. It was for $1.50. Take that into consideration. And then these two kids got into an argument, and then one of them had posted the other's docs. And then to kind of seem like he's all high and mighty, that same guy gave a random address to the guy he was doxing because he thought that he wouldn't do anything. But then that guy that was being threatened actually sent that fake address to somebody else, and he's the one who made the fake phone call to the SWAT team. And he said something along the lines of, this guy got into an argument with their mother, and the dad was accidentally shot, and then he's holding the mother, the sister, and brother hostage. And then when police knocked on the door, a 28-year-old male opened it, and then the SWAT team fired and shot him in the head, thus killing him. Now, they didn't say if the guy opened it with an armed weapon or anything like that, but regardless, something needs to be done about SWATting, and I feel that every single local police department needs to be aware of people making fake phone calls of hostage situations or any kind of fake threats like this, because this poor family is now broken up because of it. And as a member of the Call of Duty community, I am very, very upset. I'm very heartbroken. I'm ashamed because of this. And honestly, being a guy who is a part of the media, I guess you can say, it is a little bit scary at times, because there are people out there who will literally do this type of harassment online to you just because of something you said, just because of one simple opinion. Someone will go through the likes of tearing a person down mentally, and this kind of stuff needs to end. Gaming is supposed to be an escape. It's supposed to be an escape from all these issues in the world. And then when I read stuff like this, it really does depress me, especially since these people were a part of the Call of Duty scene. Now, this video isn't going to be monetized or anything like that. I'm not going to be making a single dime off this video because I don't ever want to make money off of family's misfortunes. But I just want you guys to know that you shouldn't take everything you see online or hear personally, because I feel that I am on the internet more than the regular person, and I'm always browsing Reddit and 4chan and other online forums, and I do see a lot of things that literally make people so mad, and they go to the likes of bullying and harassing them just because of a simple opinion they have. And yeah, I will admit, I am guilty of this sometimes. I do get a little bit heated in my discussions, but at the end of the day, I don't take it personally. I don't have a vendetta out against another guy, because at the end of the day, this is all just cyberspace, and most of the time, it's not gonna affect you in the real life. But if this means anything to you, apparently the same guy who called the SWAT team was the one who called in the fake bomb threats at UMG Dallas a few weeks ago. And I got this over on Twitter from FaZe Zuma, and he's been dealing with this guy for a while now. And honestly, this kind of harassment needs to end, and the police departments have to go and be aware of fake phone calls, because a guy lost his life tonight because of that, and hopefully the people involved are dealt with accordingly. And hopefully if you're watching this, you too will realize that you shouldn't take everything you hear online to heart, because again, at the end of the day, it's just a random person across the world talking to you, and chances are you will never see that person again, and chances are he doesn't know anything about you. And I'm also gonna work on being a better person online. So guys, if you want to read more about this, I have some links down below for you guys, and I'm also going to be following this story because I want to know what's going to happen to this guy. I want to know what type of punishment will happen, if anything, because the guy who called in might not even be based in the United States, and it really is just kind of confusing, honestly. So I'm going to try and keep up with it, but guys, tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below, and thanks for watching. Until next time, I'll see you later.